Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to
Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ. And Jesus was talking to them again in stories, and he said, "The kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who made a feast when his son was married, and sent out his servants to get the guests to the feast, and they would not come. Again, he sent out other servants with orders to say to the guests, 'See, I have made ready my feast. My ox and my fatted beast have been killed, and all things are ready. Come to the feast.' But they gave no attention and went about their business, one to his farm, another to his shop, and the rest put violent hands on his servant and did evil things to them and put them to death. But the king, angry, and he sent his armies, and those who had put his servants to death, he gave them to destruction, burning down their town with fire. And he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but the guests were not good enough. Go to the crossroads and get all of those whom you see to come to the bride feast.' And those servants went out to the streets and got together all those who they met, bad and good, and the feast was full of guests. But when the king came in to see the guests, he saw a man there who had not put on a guest robe. And he said to him, 'Friend, how you came here not having a guest robe?' And the man said nothing. And the king said to the servants, 'Tie him up on his hands and feet and put him out into the dark, and there will be weeping and cries of sorrow. For out of all to whom the good news has come, only a small number will receive salvation.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is a very strange gospel. Why do we throw someone out because he does not have proper clothes? It's an allegory. It's not in right time or anything like that, but let's look at this. The first guests, were the people of Israel. They refused to go. First, two groups of slaves who send the invitation are the prophets of the Old Covenant, which is why some of them are beaten and killed. That city that was destroyed by fire, that is is Jerusalem. The slaves were sent to the streets to invite anyone who wants to come are the apostles, followers of Jesus after the resurrection, who brought together the church. And the church, the one that Matthew knew very well, was filled with both good and bad, righteous people and unrighteous people, deserving people and undeserving people. Everyone, good, bad, and those people who were indifferent, who really did not care. The second group is very different than the first group. Very different. Matthew is telling us about the early Christian belief that in spite of the words of the prophets and John the Baptist, Israel and her leaders really ignored God's invitation to the wonderful Messiah, the wonderful heavenly banquet for his son, Jesus. So they themselves become rejected. And the church is made by the apostles. Everyone else, poor women, Gentiles, those people who are ignored, all of them are invited. The apostles are not to judge people, but only to invite them. This is really big. The second coming, the final judgment, when the king walks in this story, and for the first time he looks around at the people who are there, and he spots someone who is not ready. A person who is not ready appears to not be dressed properly. But dressing is not the important thing. Instead, it's something else. The wedding robe is evidence putting on something else on top of the clothes. A double fire truck going by. This story about the final judgment. The king comes, and if you are real, you have to be able to say yes or no. If you reject the invitation and ignore the robe, you really aren't there. You're not ready. Guy who refuses to put on clothes becomes the symbol of everything for everyone who is invited to the feast, but seems he doesn't want to participate. He just wants to watch. We have freedom of choice. We have the freedom to say no. We have the freedom to leave and not participate. accept Jesus or refuse. If we go, it means that we must accept. Our freedom, our humanity, everything that we are demands that we have what the king gave to the foolish man in the story. That is the opportunity to leave the greatest gift we could imagine. Our gift he had already given. Stories about invitations, about God's constant, always constant stubbornness and wanting to send again invitations, send again invitation. The open door that says we can't come in to God's wonderful party. We can't come into his heaven and be part of all that he gives us. If we don't want it, that's fine. If we want it, and we go, we have to be ready. We have to be ready and prepared. This wonderful party is something that we look forward to forever. Some people are not ready. Some of them might be afraid. Some of them do not understand what God's wonderful gift could be.